So the whole kind of like evolution in NLP started with a seminal paper called Attention is All You Need, right? Which was introducing this new architecture for NLP models based on transfer learning. And BERT was the first kind of like most popular of these new generation of models. And the way they work is, in a simplistic way, without, you know, getting too technical, is that you pre-train a model on a large of text on one specific task. So for BERT, for example, it's mask filling. You give it sentences, you remove a word in the middle of the sentence, for example, and then you train the model on predicting this missing word. Right. Mm-hmm. And then you do that on a very large corpus of text, usually, you know, a slice of the web. Mm-hmm. Right. And then you get a model, a pre-trained model that has some kind of like understanding of text that you can then fine tune. Mm-hmm. Hence, you know, the name transfer learning, because you can go from one kind of like pre-training task to other fine tuning tasks. You can fine tune this model, for example, on classification, right? Mm-hmm. By giving it like a couple of thousands of examples of a text and classification for customer support emails that I was talking about, classification urgent and not urgent, mm-hmm. right? And after that, the model is surprisingly good at classifying a new text that you give it based on urgency. And it's going to tell you, okay, this message, there is like 90% chance it's urgent based on what I've learned in the pre-training and in the fine tuning.
And so, like, for example, with BERT, I guess, you know, you have a model that can fill in, you know, missing words. How do you actually turn that into a model that, say, classifies customer support messages?
Yeah, with fine tuning, you fine tune kind of like adding a layer. You know, you fine tune this model to perform on your specific task. And that's kind of like in a more kind of like a long-term way. I think that's a very interesting way of doing machine learning, because intuitively, you almost feel like it's the right way to do machine learning, in the sense that what we've seen in the past with machine learning, and especially for startups, a lot of them have kind of like sold this dream of doing machine learning and doing some sort of like a data network effect on machine learning, right? Because there's this assumption that you're going to give more data to the model and then it's going to perform better. And I think that's true, but the challenge has always been that you have more data, and so your model performs incrementally better, but only on what you're able to do already, right? Mm-hmm. So if you're doing, I don't know, time series prediction, maybe you have like 1 billion data point, right? And your model performs at 90% accuracy. You add like maybe 9 billion, 10 billion additional data points, and your model is going to perform at, you know, 90.5% accuracy, right? And that's great. I mean, that's good improvement. That's something you need, but it doesn't give the kind of, you know, increased performance that you're really expecting from a typical network effect, in the sense that it doesn't make your result like 100x, 10x, 100x better than without it. With transfer learning, it's a bit different, because you not only kind of like improve incrementally the accuracy on one task, you give it more ability to solve other tasks. And so you actually not only increase the accuracy, but you increase the capabilities of what your model is able to do. And so I won't go into kind of like the crazy Musk type kind of like prediction, but if you take actually Elon Musk kind of like OpenAI founding kind of like story, where he's saying like, you know, we need to bring the whole community together to contribute to something open source for everyone. Intuitively, you could think that could come with actually transfer learning, in the sense that you could envision a world where every single company is contributing with their know, data sets with their compute, with their weights, the machine learning model weights, to, you know, build this giant kind of like open source models that would be able to do, you know, 100x more things than, you know, what each of these companies could do alone. I don't know if we're going to get there in the foreseeable future, but I feel like that's, in terms of concepts, that's something interesting to look at when you think about transfer learning as opposed to the other techniques of machine learning.
Thanks for watching this clip. You can see the full episode on our YouTube channel. And you can join our friendly Slack community with over 4,000 ML engineers to participate in paper reading groups, AMAs, and other fun events.